Just like to discuss this $1985 dollar coin that has a major lamination defect. So the material from which the coin is made, it can have flaws, it can have stringer flaws, it can have lamination flaws, and these are all planes of weakness. And during pressing, these areas can peel or form this particular colouring and shape. These are planes of weakness. All right, let's have a look at some other photos that I've taken. So there we go. So we're talking about these flaws, laminations, and some of the metal is pulled out here, and they represent like a darker colour. And you can clearly see there the plane of weakness is going right through. So this is like a lamination in the planchet material. It is a rolled defect. Stringers can be rolled and made longer and bigger. So this is a planchet material defect rather than a die cracking or caused by the actual pressing die. So the coin is the 1985 coin, which is the second year the coins were made. It is interesting if we go back to the first picture, we can clearly see next to the rim a groove. And this particular groove is quite prevalent with the 1985 dollar coins, but not so much the 1984 coins. These groovings can be quite valuable in the 1984 coins, and also where the 1985 coins are new. But let's concentrate on the lamination defect in this instance. We'll just go through the photos again. Clearly you can see this is the sort of lamination, the pattern that you have. So if you see these on other coins, look for this sort of pattern. There is no raised edge. So the actual die, the pressing die, has no cracks in it and is probably quite sound. It is just that the planchet material has a line of weakness, or could it just be a stringer which then fails and also gives you these areas. Sometimes this whole area can be stripped because there is a weakness in this area. So I just would like to end the video by actually playing the lamination video that I've taken.